Hey guys, what's up? It's Andy. In this video, I'm going to teach you three psychological tricks that'll make you more attractive to your customers. This right here is going to change everything. Okay guys, here we go. So the first tip is going to be look stylish. Do me a favor. If you really want to level up and go to the next level, get a pen and piece of paper and take some notes. If you want to be one of the best top performers in the country, guess what? You're going to have to what? Make people want to be attracted to being around you and not want to leave your side. Well, how do you do that? The first tip is going to be to look stylish. This is really important. I want you to do me a favor and I'm going to let you take the test. Take the Andy test right here. So I want you to walk into like a Chick-fil-A or something. Doesn't matter where you go, walk into a Chick-fil-A. Walk up to the front and I want you to ask the person serving you that's taking your order, say, hey, I'll give you $100 cash if you can guess what I do for a living. 100, if you can just guess what I do. Go ahead, guess. If they look at you and they're like, man, I don't know, but I know that you run a business because you look great, you look sharp, and you look like you're a business person. Bam, you're on the right track. We're doing good. But if they look at you and they're like, man, I don't know. Guess what? You don't look like a business person. Do you want to be the trusted advisor? Yes. Do you want to be the person that's the expert that the customer looks up to? Remember this. When someone sees you for the very first time, do you think that they're judging you? Absolutely. Just like you're judging them every single time. So as people walk up to you and they're judging you, listen, what you're about to do is be giving this person advice in the future, later on during the sale, even financial advice. You may be even working out their money with them and how they should spend their money as you're negotiating with them. Now, how, right, does it feel to negotiate and to work a deal with someone who doesn't look like a professional business person? There's ordinary, lame, 99% business people that still dress nice, and then there's stylish ones. Look, you say, Andy, define stylish for me. Let me explain what I mean here, okay? Keep yourself nice and groomed tight, all right? Make sure you brush your teeth to take care of yourself. Some of you, you need to whiten your teeth. It's just the truth. Take care of yourself. Go to the next level, because when you take care of yourself, it shows someone else that you can take care of them. How hard is it to take advice from somebody that doesn't look like they're taking their own advice? You picking up what I'm putting down? So stay stylish. Look good. Make sure you take care of your hair. Keep it nice and clean. A lot of people need it. I get a haircut every week. Some of you need a haircut every other week. Know when it's time and get your hair cut before in advance so you look nice and clean and sharp. Also, own an iron or take your clothes to the dry cleaners. Even if you're wearing a polo shirt, make sure it's ironed and pressed and not stained. If you stain a shirt, throw it away. It's done. Listen to me. Do you invest 10% of your income every month into getting new clothes to keep you look sharp to make more money? If you did, your income would increase because you would look more attractive to your customers. I really feel like being attractive is one of the things that most people don't think about. Do you think this, and by the way, there's some of you right now that you're judging me and you don't like it when I say the word attracted, okay? I don't care how great looking you are. It don't matter to me. Would you agree if you dressed nicer, if you had more stylish clothes, you would be better looking, yes or no? The answer is yes. Why aren't you? You know what? Because you're on the 4-lane highway and you're like everybody else. So three ways to make people more attracted to you is going to start out number one with stylish. By the way, dress shoes. Think about this, dress shoes. How nice are your shoes that you're wearing? Do you take care of them? Are they nice and clean? Or are they scratched up and it looks like you mowed the yard? I see salespeople running in dress shoes, right? And I see some salespeople running in what? Tennis shoes. Tennis shoes with slacks isn't cool. I know a lot of you think it is, and you say, Andy, my feet hurt, I wear tennis shoes. Listen to me. There are ways that you can buy nice insoles on nice dress shoes to do what? Run, work in them, and succeed at the highest level and still look classy and great. Now, at the end of the day, I'm not telling you how to live your life and to change your tennis shoes. That's not my goal. But I am telling you that the more attractive that you are, the better you take care of yourself, the longer people are gonna wanna stay around you. Okay guys, here we go. Second psychological trick to make everyone attracted to you. Make it fun. Write that down. Make it fun. Take some notes on what I'm about to tell you. Let me explain this to you. So, good looking guys, a lot of the time, approach hot girls. And what happens is they can't get the date because they're too serious and they're relying just on their looks. Now, we talked about in the last part, the first trick, be attractive, look great, be stylish. That's important. But the most important thing is be funny, be fun. Think about it. Have you ever seen a guy and he's not even that good looking, but he's got a smoking hot chick with him? And you're like, Dude, man, how is that working out? Let me explain why. He's fun. He's fun. That's the reason. I'm married way up. You know how? Because I'm fun. I don't take everything so serious. I like to be quirky. I like to be funny. I like to laugh and I like to joke, okay? In order to maintain and keep someone's attention for long periods of time, you gotta be around somebody that they wanna be around. How many times in your life, right? How many times have you been around somebody and you're like, man, I can't wait to get away from this person. Truly can't wait. You know why? Because they're so boring or their personality doesn't match yours. Now think about it for a second. As we go out every day, and as if I'm talking to an automotive sales pro who wants to actually build a relationship with the customer, build rapport, and you want to make sure, and let's say it takes 2 hours to sell a vehicle, that customer stays with you for 2 hours. You have to be fun. It's that simple. And how do you do it? Number one, you got to start working on your personality. So a lot of people have character, but they don't have charisma and they don't have personality. This is extremely important. So what I did is that I used to watch comedians tell jokes. I would literally go and just watch and study comedians on TV. And what I would do is I would learn jokes. I would learn how they would make things funny. I would learn how they would tie in things to make it funny. Why? Well, number one, I'm more attractive to my customers and I can serve them at the highest level when I'm funny or when I'm fun. People don't think about money when the person they're dealing with, it's fun. Look, I've seen this happen every day. Customer comes on the lot, they say hi to a sales pro, they say what's up. Within 2 minutes, the customer's getting shown a vehicle, and you know what happens? The customer and the person are not having any fun, and all the customer can ask is, what's your best price? What's the price? What kind of deal can they make me on this? You know why? Because there's no connection. They're not attracted to be around that person for very much longer. They're wondering, how fast can I get this over with? And by the way, they'll buy in spite of the salesperson as long as the deal's right, which means you're never gonna make any money. So what happens? If you go and you actually have fun and you're funny and you have a personality, all your customers are gonna wanna spend more time with you. They're not gonna wanna part ways with you. And guess what? You're gonna build a closer rapport relationship with you and that customer. And listen, you'll end up getting sales you shouldn't have gotten. You'll end up getting farther than most people could get. I used to be a TO manager when I was younger. What that means is that whenever a deal wasn't going right or when a customer was ready to leave, I would be the guy that would go intervene within 30 seconds. I had to build a best friend, make them all laugh, and then close the deal. What I did is I did one thing that was my secret magical psychological skill, which was I had fun. I would go in and I would knew that these people wanted to leave because the conversation that they wanted to have with the sales pro they were dealing with had ended. It wasn't sometimes that the deal was bad. And by the way, even if the deal wasn't right, they would have worked it out with someone who was actually fun. Most people don't understand that. So I hope you take this, steal that trick. Let's get on to trick number three. Okay guys, psychological trick number three. Write this down. You guys ready to grow? Unshakable confidence. Damn. Let me explain what I mean here, okay? This is something that'll change your life. You know what unshakable confidence means? It means certainty in yourself. Look, it's an identity that you have about yourself that you know you're the expert in the field. By the way, you're not closed-minded. You're in the growth mindset. Your glass, you know, it isn't full. You're always ready to learn. And what you want to do is you want to show people love and you're great at what you do. You know what that does? It makes people be really attracted to you because you're different. Have you ever noticed a lot of people that think they're really good at what they do? Guess what? They're not super loving to people. They're really not. They're stuck up. Have you ever seen a beautiful girl, you walk by her and you're almost thinking that she's not going to smile back at you because she probably looks good? But what happens if she smiled back at you and she was like, hey, how you doing? You're like, man, she's really nice. Do you see that? What happens is she has confidence in herself about who she is, but also she's super loving to other people, no matter how great she is or how great she looks. My point to you being is this: when I go and say hi to someone else, you know what I do? I have a certainty inside of myself that I know that I'm gonna get a smile back when I smile back at you. I know that whenever I speak to someone, right, that they're gonna wanna speak with me because I make them feel significant and important while I'm speaking to them. Look, I said something, it was unshakable confidence, not confidence. And by the way, there's competence, okay, which creates more confidence, which means if you're training, you're gonna get more confidence. But also there's arrogance, there's cockiness, and there's confidence. Confidence is key in this business. Unshakable means this: if I'm talking to you and you reject me, it's not a big deal. And by the way, my state doesn't change. Let's go ahead. If you got a pen and piece of paper, write down this. Unshakable confidence means that my state will not change when I'm rejected. Okay, write that down. How many of you guys, right? When someone tells you no, or they don't do what you want them to do, how many of you guys thought that you were confident when you were going and asking for the sale, but then when the customer said no and didn't give you the answer they want, and maybe even asked two or three more times and they still wouldn't give it to you? You know what you did? You lost your confidence. You know what you did? You got deflated and your state changed. Now let me ask you this. Let's just sum up this entire training, which I hope this has helped you and changed everything. By the way, at this point right now, if you enjoy the video, share it with a friend. Comment below. Let me know your favorite part. Give me a thumbs up. And guess what? Make sure you subscribe to the channel. I always put out great content that's going to help you level up, crush it, kill it, and go to the next gear, which is going to get you to the next level financially and just in life to get what you want. But I want you to think about it. Just slow down for a minute. Think about this. How many times have you seen a salesperson, right, go out and shake someone's hand? They're super excited. They're jacked up. They've got energy, right? You know what I'm saying? They're alive. And then they spend an hour with them and they're still alive. And that customer and that salesperson has gotten an opportunity to know each other. But then when something doesn't go just the way the salesperson wants it to go, because in the first hour, we weren't asking for money. The first 90% of the time, we're doing what? Outside on the lot, building value, making sure the customer loves us. The last 10% of the time, we're inside collecting 100% of the money. Guess what? That last 10% of the time that doesn't go the first 90% the way that it went, and they say no, or they're asking for concessions that you don't want to give, do you change your state? If you change your state, you do not have unshakable confidence. Now, my goal is to teach you how to have it. How do you have it? Number one, you gotta have massive certainty. Massive certainty. And how do you do that? Well, you do it by training. All the top sales pros that I train that are making $500,000 to $1 million a year, you know how they're there? They're there because what they do, they practice. Repetition is the mother of skill. If you wanna be extremely good at unshakable confidence, you gotta practice, you gotta study, you gotta record yourself every day, and you gotta study people who have unshakable confidence so that you can get it. Your goal is that if you really wanna win and you wanna have unshakable confidence, you have to be the initiator in life and not wait for other people to initiate things. You've gotta start walking by people and saying, hey, how you doing? Hey, what's going on? Hey, and guess what? Whenever things aren't going your way, don't put a frown on your face. Don't put your head down, put your head up, smile more, and increase your energy, increase your confidence. It's a learned skill, and guess what? You gotta subconsciously do it on demand. Your customers need you to help them through the purchasing process, which is give them reasons and excuses why they should say yes. And by the way, why you're giving them the yeses and why they should do it, if they continue to say no, if you can't go in the front door, go in the back, the side, the chimney, in the basement, you're gonna find a way in. But don't lose your confidence along the way. Guys, these are three psychological tricks that'll show you how to build an attractive relationship with you and any client, any customer, any person. This works in every area of life, and this has greatly helped me get to where I'm going. Guys, take this video, practice it. Remember, share it with somebody. Make sure you like, subscribe, and comment below on what was your favorite part. Love you guys. See you in the next video.